for someone starting out in the voiceover industry, what would your, if you had any advice, what would the advice be to them?
Well, I'm going to give the answer I kind of always give. Sorry, everybody. First of all, you're an actor. At the end of the day, it's another acting job. It just happens that you can work in your pajamas. But it's an acting job. So acting training, voice training, improv training are the three major things that I would recommend. Watch a lot of, you know, if you want to be a commercial voice actor, watch the commercials. Don't fast forward. You know, don't watch them illegally on, you know, something. Watch the commercials, watch anime, watch cartoons. Just hear what's trending and all that. There are some amazing websites. Dee Bradley Baker is an amazing voice actor who has a website where he gives advice. Steve Bloom is another amazing voice actor. He has a Facebook page called Blumvox, where different people who are trying to get into the industry all communicate and talk to each other and give advice. For me, it's a little different. I started when I was a kid. So it's hard for me to tell someone now how to get in, but I do know that at the core of all of my work is my training. And when I'm having trouble in the booth finding something or, you know, oh gosh, I have to, you know, I just came from one job where I'm playing a neurotic 10-year-old girl, and now I have to go to this other job where I'm a kick-ass soldier, I have to switch gear. You know, that's where all your training kicks in switching your mindset and just fully going into whatever character you need to go into. So training, and then research. I mean, it's funny how often I get asked questions by my friends who want to get into it about things that are like really easy to Google. So just sit down at that computer, how to be a voice actor, and you'll be amazed at what you find. And a lot of it is really good advice. A lot of people think that it's an easy way to make money. And they say things like, how do I sign up to do that? Instead, I don't want to be a real actor. I just want to be a voice actor. And I have to say, I'm not offended, but you have to be careful how you say that to some people, because it's almost, in some ways I find it harder because I don't have, you know, I can't roll my eyes to show that, oh my, you know, there's things that you can't use your face to say. So it's all in your voice. And that's trickier sometimes. And the industry's changed so much too, with so many different ways of earning a living as an actor. And I say earning a living in quotes because, you know, podcasters and, you know, short films, it's great. You can go make your own stuff now and be discovered that way. But it's not necessarily, you know, the money that people used to think of when they thought, I'll just be an actor and money will pour down on me. So, yeah, the industry has definitely changed. And I'm very lucky to ever be working. I never take it for granted.